they were unable to do better for the country. Then finally it came to the, in the hands of so-called elected governments. Actually, the elected ones are all old militaries. So, outwardly it is a civilian or democratic government. But in essence, it is the same militaries who had ruled Myanmar for about 50 years. to the faith of our Lord. We are not killed, we are not destroyed, we are not looted, our properties were not taken away, our citizenship was not taken away in the time of military rulers. These so-called democratic governments have done everything on us, but their mentality based on discriminations and dominations. Myanmar politics is based on ethnicity. Almost all ethnic people in Myanmar is not satisfied with the rulings of present militaries. But present democratic governments is trying to solve the ethnic armed groups confrontation with the government. And yet, it is 4 years. There's not final agreement just for ceasefire. After ceasefire, there would come political dialogue. I don't know what will be and who will be that political dialogue. After all, militaries are willing to make peace with the one who have arms in hands. They are not willing to make peace with the people who do not have arms in hands. That are the Rohingyas in the western part of Myanmar in Rakhine State. According to international law, IDPs should be promptly resettled in their original place. But it is 3 years. There is no rays of light that Rohingyas should be resettled. In contrast, Rohingya refugees were about 150,000. So-called Rakhine refugees were 3,500, according to official records. All Rakhine peoples were resettled and provided with decent homes, provided money by foreign countries. Actually, these monies were given for Rohingyas, the donors were Indonesia and Turkey. But Myanmar government did not use one single kyat to resettle these Rohingyas. So, it is up to the democracy conscious Myanmar peoples and international community to press Myanmar government to reconcile to reasons and law, not international law, Myanmar law. Myanmar law has no clause to discriminate minorities, to discriminate peoples of other faith, to discriminate people who are not similar to them in culture and appearance. So, it is 3 years Rohingya, 150,000 Rohingyas are in IDP camps. Everything is said about the camps and many will say about in detail. What I want to say is, Rohingya has been subjected, first, distortion of their history. Rohingya is Rohingya, Rohingya was Rohingya. In Myanmar, after independence, there were two censuses, one in 1973, another in 1983. In all censuses, Rohingya has responded as Rohingya to be registered. But in 1973 census, Rohingya were set in census report. Pakistanis and Indians, okay, no problem. People do not know it that there is Pakistanis and Indians, they will register in the final report. In 1988, these Pakistanis and Indians become Bangladeshi. Very inconsistent policy of Myanmar government. Then they came to a strip of our identity. That means they are strip of our identity Rohingya, and they are forcing us today to claim to be Bengali. Unless we admit or confess Bengali, they say this IDP will remain for the coming century. You should confess that you are Bengali and you came from Bangladesh recently. You have to apply for naturalized citizen. Naturalized citizenship applicant should confess that I came so and so from so and so country. I want to be Burmese citizen now. How can the morals of the Rohingya people who have been there for many centuries to admit that we came from India and Bangladesh? It is not possible. They can be subjected to annihilation and they may die. They cannot afford to confess Bangladeshi and they arrived recently. For this policy, to carry out this policy, to implement this policy, Myanmar government had hired some famous historian, professors, and ex-diplomats. What they are doing at present, there is no Rohingya in Myanmar history. In British time, census, there is no Rohingya. These are recent comers from Bangladesh. And then came the questions of our rights. Right means there are various rights. Most important one, the basic one, is the citizenship rights. Myanmar has no identification cards in British time. After independence, they issued identification cards to people. Who are citizens, they are issued national registration cards. Who are foreigner, they were issued foreign registration cards. Without these two cards, no one can live in Myanmar. You will be subjected to arrest and deportation according to Myanmar immigration law. That means all Rohingyas obtain or achieve or issued national registration cards, they enjoy full citizenship rights until 1982, new draconian, arbitrary citizenship right law. Under that law, Rohingyas were stripped of their citizenship. And now they are going to say, you have to apply for third class citizenship, naturalized citizenships. It is a big problem. There are, in Rohingya community, I think most people do not know it. Rohingyas are not only Muslim. Not Muslims are Rohingya. The ancient people who live in Arkan from early time up to now are Rohingyas. In this Rohingya community, they are Buddhists, Hindus, and Muslims. Accidentally, majority are Muslim. Those Buddhists, Rohingyas were taken as indigenous peoples of Myanmar. They are called Maramaji or Borua. But the question of Hindus and Muslims is different. They are not accepted as not indigenous people, even not as citizens of this country. Myanmar Immigration Department and Immigration Ministers used to say, you are Bengali. Your complexion is similar to Bengali. Your culture is similar to Bengali. And You are Muslim, you cannot be our citizen. That's the point, inconsistency. Those Myanmarji who are Buddhist, they are also like us. Their culture, language, everything is similar to Bengali. More similar to Bengali than Rohingya. But they are accepted as indigenous peoples of Myanmar. So it is what we call it. It is the faith of what is called the... Sorry, it's our faith. Again, Myanmar government, present Myanmar government is very stubborn. They say the right of action is in our hand. Rohingya or not Rohingya, it is our internal affairs, domestic affairs. Handling of this Rohingya issue is in our hand. We can do whatever we wish, we like. So what they like? They like us to make nationalized citizen with Bengali identity. This is not complete for all Rohingyas. There is a town in this central Rakhine state, it is called Miebo. 1,000 people applied by pressure from the government for nationalized citizenship. Only 200 were issued that nationalized citizenship card. What about the 800 rest? That means Myanmar feels free to do whatever they like. Say the United Nations resolution put in the past year 2 times during the past year. It is non-binding. Myanmar have no obligation to abide by this resolution. Again, Myanmar said, the Rakhine state is calm and quiet. There is peace, no problem. Then this ODN accepted, keeping 150,000 refugees in squalid IDP camps. Is peace? Where is their education? Where is their health care? Where is their freedom of work, freedom of movement, freedoms of marriage, freedom of taking children? Only 2-child policy is enforced on Rohingya community in Rakhine state. So, for these refugees, there are some concerns across the world. Some NGOs and United Nations organization is helping them, aiding them, sending some material. Firstly, they were not allowed at the initial time in 2012. That means let the Rohingya refugee be starved and die. That is a part of the ethnic cleansing program. Lately, they were allowed. But when MSF have exposed, find out some explicit involvement of the security forces in the burning down and killing of peoples in Chiradan village in Mongdong, MSF was ordered to leave Rakhine state. In 2014, March, other NGO offices were destroyed, stores were looted and burned down, and ordered them all to go out of situ, the capitals of Rakhine state. But luckily, after some months, these NGOs were allowed to operate again, but with limited access to IDPs and needy people. They should take permission prior to go to the camps from the authorities of Rakhine state. Only with limited opportunity, they get the chance to go to IDP camps and needy people. These are not enough for the life of a human group. They can supply only 1/3 or half of their needs. So these people are starving. These people lost their hope in their future. These people So much desperate and fearful, why fearful? There is daily, continuous arrest, extortion, arbitrary detention, and so all sort of persecution continuing. People lost hope in their future. They don't see any ray of light that they would have a peaceful life. So people start fleeing the land, and they are floating in Andaman Sea, and some are going under the ground in Malaysia and in Thailand, what you will call traffickers' hand. So this is a sorrowful tragedy of Rohingya. These all are meant by man. This is not natural or something. Man-made tragedy, man-made catastrophe. So it should be solved primarily. The speaker said in the morning, and Dr. Uparadin also said, it is the responsibility of the government to protect its own people. But Myanmar government is not protecting them. Instead of protecting, they are trying to drive these people from the Rakhine State. In Arkan Post, there are Myanmar naval ships, a lot of naval ships. Still today, we never heard that Myanmar Navy had taken action against any human trafficking boat. That means they are complicit. They are encouraging and facilitating these human traffickers. First, we have to stop these human trafficking. Once there is human trafficking, and in the other side, there are people who are waiting for transportation to Malaysia, Indonesia, and Thailand. So it will never cease. In one side, we have to stop, we have to eradicate the cells of all human trafficking in Thailand, Malaysia, Indonesia, and anywhere. In another side, we have to give protection. We have to give life. We have to give facilities for livelihood, for survival, to those people who are in IDP camps and who are also in confinement in the villages. They cannot move from village to village. They don't have any access to livelihood. They cannot walk. They cannot go to the sea for fishing. They cannot go to the forest for something, firewood or something. They are very restrictively confined. So their life are very sorrowful and awful. If Myanmar government is not going to protect them, I think, and I know, there are resolution in the United Nations General Assembly in 2005 that is called United Nations General Assembly General Assembly World Summit Outcome Document. And that document, international community have an obligation to rescue, to protect the people who is not protected by its own government. So my appeal today, lastly, is international community have to find out some ways and channels to rescue these people, to protect these people, to resettle these people in their own places, and to give them full basic rights as human beings. I think international community will consider it seriously. There are a lot of people from various countries. Especially I want to request to Norwegian, Norway government, because Norway is very important for Myanmar. Norway is giving a lot of money to Myanmar government for making peace with armed groups, and there is Norway, huge Norway investment in the country. If Norway takes some responsibility and some initiative, I think Rohingya program will be solved. We are not seeking new rights, as Dr. Okar so said. We ask Myanmar government until 1982 law, we are full citizens of Myanmar. Please restore us, reinstate us that position again. It cannot be done by so-called interfaith dialogue. Interfaith dialogue is going in Myanmar for the last 3 years. No effect, no result. It can be done with the warm words of President Thein Sein. Rohingyas are our people. No one can harm them, loot them, kill them. They should have full freedom. One sentence will finish for us. It won't take times or decades, as Dr. Walker said. I don't agree with him. There should not be short-term, long-term, medium-term planning to resettle Rohingya. Only one sentence of President Thein Sein will enough for our full right and full protection and full comfortability in the country. We respect Burma, we love Burma, we love Rakhine State much. I am 70 years old, every day I am longing Rakhine, I want to go to Rakhine, and I want to die there. Rakhine is our birthplace, the birthplace of our ancestors. We will never abandon it. We will take it and eat our own right in some way in the future. Okay, thank you all.
Okay. Thank you. Now the next speaker is Gokhamani.
Yeah. That's fine.
Yeah. Okay, Utahi will go first. I think that we're gonna need to bring the
screen down.
Things are gonna have a lot of Jevan. How can I believe you? Most Rohingyas are not loyal. Repressing law.